Exo One is a traversal adventure game from Exbelative, where you pilot a strange interplanetary vessel that manipulates gravity and uses momentum to navigate unique planets. The story is told through non-voice captions from a variety of characters. Some are ancillary, like reporters or engineers, while others seem directly involved in events. But few are named, and the ones that are don't get satisfying introductions or explanations as to how they factor in. Flashing imagery during opening cutscenes is also randomly thrown into levels, and seems to hint at things I can only assume are meant to be important, like a crew of astronauts or the planet Jupiter. But I couldn't make heads or tails of what I was being shown or why for the entirety of the adventure. Despite being mostly confused by the plot, objectives are clear. You need to get your mysterious flying orb to the massive light in the distance, which is some sort of interplanetary railgun, launching you to your next destination. Using the vessel's unique movement mechanics, you can increase its gravity tenfold, allowing it to gain massive speed on a downslope and then return it to its normal moon-like physics to take off into the sky from ramps. The vessel can also flatten itself out to glide while airborne and perform a slight double and triple jump as long as it has enough energy to do so. You'll need to use the terrain and atmosphere of each planet to gain and maintain speed. Piloting the vessel effectively enough to do so is the bulk of the gameplay. It can be puzzle-like to figure out how to catch enough air to glide through energy-recharging clouds that provide speed boosts and hang time. Differences in planet topography and weather, like vast oceans or high winds, add obstacles for you to contend with, at times without the full functionality of the vessel, which can be a challenge. Control of the vessel is intuitive. You'll fall into a natural rhythm, switching between modes and adapting to the surroundings to reach your end goal. It's easy to slip into a zen-like trance while soaring through the sky, and a sense of speed and altitude once you really get going is thrilling, especially with no way to take damage or die. Each planet offers hard-to-reach power-ups for your energy limits as collectibles, but are otherwise barren. They are, however, quite distinct from one another, and offer memorable characteristics for you to adapt to. The skies and lighting create an incredible atmosphere, ranging from serene to frightful at times, and a use of depth of field and film grain can give sections a very cinematic look, but they can be turned off if you find them annoying. Ground textures, on the other hand, are noticeably flat and lacking in detail, so much so that high speeds can't hide them. My only complaint regarding the music is that there isn't enough of it. The contemplative orchestral pieces fade away too soon, leaving you with only the sounds of the natural environment and the whirring sci-fi engines of the vessel, which are amazing in their own right. Exo One is a haunting blend of gameplay mechanics and meditation. It's a short experience, coming in just under 2.5 hours, but it's something I'd play through again for the sole purpose of clearing my mind and zoning out. Exo One is out November 18th for PC, Xbox One, Xbox Series X and S, and Xbox Game Pass.